What is this word lean? So in the class, I used the term lean UX, lean agile. You hear this word a few times. I just wanted to give you some grounding on kind of like where it comes from and why we use it and what it means. So lean startup really kind of popularized this idea of lean, just at least in like the common vernacular of how we speak about it. This was a book by Eric Ries, which we mentioned in the class. And some of the main principles. So this is his story about launching his company IMVU and lessons learned. There's a bit of like, there's not as much, these other books here, which I'm going to mention, are a little bit more of like how to do it, a little more practical. This is a little, I mean, it's nonfiction, but it reads a little more like a story and has some principles throughout it. So just to set you up with, you know, expectations. But I can just, this one part here about agile. So there's a system called Agile Development, and it's agile for a good reason, because the teams on it, they're able to employ changes quickly, stay light on their feet, and be highly responsive to changes in the business requirements of the product owner. So a lot of what this book's about is how to have an idea, do it really quickly, fail quickly, learn quickly, and change quickly. It's all about building in quickly. The opposite of this book would be, hey, we have a $100,000 budget. We're gonna build this site in our garage or in our big agency house for a year, and then we're gonna big release it, and people are gonna come to us, and they're gonna throw their money and gold on us, and we're gonna be mad, super rich, awesome, Madison Avenue or whatever, big. But no, this is about it's the opposite of that. This is about like doing it small and agile, and it's not just for startups. It's for and he talks about that as well. So this is a good one. The other two are part of a series that Eric Ries, the author of that book, it's part of a series on lean. The first one is Lean UX, and this really is nice because there's a good part in here. How is UX different than lean UX? Generally, people kind of use it the same way, but there's right up front, there's some good principles in the definition. And one of the principles of lean UX is problem-focused teams. So you're focusing on the problem as opposed to the set of features. So what that means is it's not like, hey, here's a bunch of features, make these, and giving it to the developer, but rather having the developer in on the ideation meeting, having the developer with the client, and letting the developer diagnose that problem with the user experience designer, with the designer, have the whole team work on it together. So that's problem-focused teams, focusing on the problem, not just like the specs, not just waterfall where it's like, here, do this. Another principle, I'm going to share three of them. The second one is a shared understanding. A shared understanding, and I love this. A shared understanding is the collective knowledge of the team that builds up over time as the team works together. So a collective knowledge. You know that feeling, right? When you have a team together and everybody just like gets it. Maybe it's a soccer team that you played on. Maybe it's a significant other. You just make each other laugh and you just know the jokes without even, it's like that kind of like shared understanding is what he's talking about. And it saves a lot of time when you're implementing features, when you're bringing the thing to market, and it's awesome. And that's what Lean UX is about. It's about learning together and not in separate silos. So that's the second one. And the third one is making over analysis. So in UX, this is the idea, it's better to just make something today and have one user try it and give you feedback than thinking about how to do it, having tons of meetings, not actually doing it, and then launching it, with big fanfare in 6 months, that story I keep telling. Not the best way to do it, right? So the idea is doing it quick and getting it out there. Now you may be thinking, hey, Chris, but you said don't just start with code, right? Don't just start building it. That contradicts what you're saying. You're saying don't start with code, but also code something the first day and release it. Well, that's a good question. there's a fair balance between like coding and just coding and coding and coding and coding and coding features that nobody wants, and doing a minimal amount of code, or prototyping, or just talking to users, that's lean UX. It's not necessarily just coding the first day, but it's getting feedback quickly. So, really like this book if you're more interested in learning lean principles.